JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 2nd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Thursday during the Asian session Friday. It lost the most ground versus NZD and AUD, while it was found virtually unchanged against the Japanese yen. Now, the weakness in the US dollar and the Japanese yen, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, suggests that markets continue trading in a risk-on fashion. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that most major EU indices closed in the green, with the only exception being Spain's IBEX 35, which closed virtually unchanged. Investors' appetite was boosted even further, with Nasdaq gaining the most among Wall Street's main indices, and the S&P 500 hitting a fresh record high, surpassing the round figure of 4,000. The positive morale rolled over into the Asian session today as well. It seems that investors continue to cheer US President Biden's proposal of a $2.3 trillion worth of infrastructure investments, but they may have also got encouraged to add to their risk exposure by the upside revisions in the final market manufacturing PMIs for March from the Eurozone, the UK and the US. On top of that, the ISM manufacturing index for the month rose to 59.6 from 54.4, which is the strongest level in more than 37 years. As for today, all lights are likely to fall on the US employment report for March. The forecast for non-farm payrolls has changed and now points to a 647,000 new jobs, more than the 379,000 in February. The unemployment rate is anticipated to have declined to 6% from 6.2%, while average hourly earnings are forecast to have slowed to 0.1% month over month from 0.2%, something that would take the year-over-year rate down to 4.5% from 5.3%. The forecasts point to a strong report, which is likely to confirm that the US economy is recovering from the damages of the pandemic at a fast pace. This is likely to support the US dollar at the time of the release. However, the big question is how equities will perform when they open again on Tuesday. Today, stock markets across most of the nations under our radar will be closed due to celebration of Good Friday and will remain closed on Monday due to Easter Monday. In our view, how equities will perform depends on whether the report would revive inflation fears, which could lead to speculation that the Fed may start normalizing policy sooner than previously expected. If we don't get inflation fears, equities and other risk-linked assets are likely to gain, while safe havens like the yen are likely to come under selling interest. On the other hand, fresh inflation fears may result in the opposite market reaction. As for our view, we believe that the first case may be true, as the Fed has clearly said that any spike in inflation in the months to come is likely to prove to be temporary, and that inflation will meet their goal in the years after 2023. Remember that at the press conference following the latest FOMC gathering, Fed Chair Powell also noted that it is too early to start discussing tapering quantitative easing, while the updated dot plot pointed to no rate hikes even in 2023. Now back to the US dollar, we believe that it is safer to exploit any gains of it against the Japanese yen. On the one hand, improving risk appetite is likely to weigh on the yen due to its safe haven status, While on the other one, the yen could stay under selling interest even if the employment report revived fresh inflation fears. Why? This may result in higher US Treasury yields, which combined with a Bank of Japan pledge to keep its long-dated Japanese government bond yields near zero, will widen the yield differential between the two nations, thereby pushing dollar yen higher. Now, as for the rest of today's events, as we already noted, today is Good Friday in most nations under our radar, and so there are no other economic releases on the agenda. We only have one speaker, and this is Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.